Hello guys, and welcome to a new video from Hackathons. In this video, we will use Python to execute shell command and we will learn how to run them in this video. Fortunately, with the help of Python, we get a lot of functionality to run scripts. Learning how to run shell commands in Python opens a door for us to automate computer tasks in a structured and scalable way. So the first module that we will be using is OS module that is used for all processes connected to the working of our computer. So I'll import that and then I will say os.system and inside the parentheses I will type in a keyword called echo and then I'll say hello from Hackathons. And if I run this program, as you can see, the output shows hello from Hackathons, because the echo command prints out the standard output that is given inside the parentheses, that is hello from Hackathons. Likewise, we can also go into the cd command systems by using such a method called as home directory is equal to os.system and inside the parentheses I will say cd and then I will put this wavy symbol and now I will print a statement saying that cd ran with exit code %d, which is specifier for an integer, and then I'll place the percent symbol and I will say home dir. Okay, and now if I run this program, as you can see, it said cd ran with exit code 1 since there was an error saying that the system cannot find the path specified. But yes, that output will be different for everyone. So you can try that out. So the OS system function executes a command, prints any output of the command to the console and returns that exit code command. But now we will make use of the subprocess module that is present in Python. The subprocess recommends executing shell command, which gives us a flexibility to suppress the output shell commands or chain a set of inputs and outputs. Okay, and first thing, let me import subprocess. Then on the next line, I will create a variable name list files is equal to subprocess and I will use the run function to run a set of commands, and inside that I will open a Python list and I will say ls comma dash, and then I shall just simply print the same statement saying that the exit code was %d, that is a format specifier for an integer, and then I'll say %listfile. And if I run this program, as you can see, it throws an output saying that total 80 and the exit code was 0, which means the process worked successfully. And this is how we ran a list of strings as input instead of a single string. And then these items were set as flags and their output was returned using the exit code 0, which means the prompt ran perfectly. We can also make use of the popen function that is responsible for the creation and management of the execution process. So what I'll say is, I'll create a variable called as process and I will say process is equal to subprocess dot p, capital P, open, and then in the bracket I will say echo echo comma, the next statement I will say more output, and then I will say std out, that is the standard output, is equal to subprocess dot pipe, which is a form of an output resource. And now I'll create two variables called as stdout, comma stderr is equal to process, the variable process that we created. And on that, I will use the communicate function to return the output on the Python prompt. And now I shall simply print these statements. So I will say process comma STDERR. And if I run this program, we get the output saying that mo output, which is coming from the p.open function that we have written here, and using the communicate function, the output is visible on a prompt screen. So that is how you make use of the p.open function. You can also make use of the subprocess .call, which is at your disposal if you want. For example, I create the variable process right over again, and then I say subprocess dot run, and inside the parenthesis I will open a Python list and I will say echo comma even more output, just a random statement that we want to get printed on a output window, and then I'll place a comma after that, and then I will say std out is equal to subprocess dot pipe. And then the universal lines, that is a inbuilt keyword present inside the function, is equal to true. And now if I run the program, as you can see, now it says even more output with a slash n, which means all the possible lines are getting printed on the output. That is because we use the keyword universal lines is equal to true, and with the std out, the output was visible on our commands. So this is how you can make use of the common subprocess module to execute shell commands using Python. Now we have given you two methods of how Python shell executes commands. The effective way of using it is using the subprocess module. However, you can also make use of the OS functionality present. So I hope you like this video. If you like the video, do drop a like and subscribe to the Hackinons YouTube channel for more fun and amazing videos.